Hello everybody, it's Theron. Welcome to Minecraft LAN Party. I believe this is episode 23. I'm up here at the top of my little mountain home. I've got a little micro farm. Really keeps me about as sustained as I need. I've got the land up here is pretty well lit, and I've got this glass ring that prevents anything from getting up here. So it's pretty safe up here, pretty much at all times. Not too bad. And I've got some endstone up here so I can grow some purpur. Although I have a much more efficient purpur farm. In the end. Alright. Oh, look. Ladder. That's right. I climbed my way up here once. Okay. So, what are we going to do today? Well, today, I say today, it's really the same day as when I recorded yesterday. No, that makes no sense whatsoever. Same as my last video. Same day. Hence, the air conditioning is still on. Bark. And, it's just the day in which I can get some recording done. I've been a little busy with stuff lately. It was my birthday recently. And I had travel up to the Bay Area to help my dad out with some stuff. And so yeah, I haven't been playing a lot. I haven't been on the server much. That looks painful, Mr. Ghast. Got something in your head. So that's I haven't been on much. Haven't recorded, ran out of stuff. I basically edited all the footage that I had and put it into videos and posted it. So I'm trying to get a little bit ahead here. I usually record sort of ahead of time. And then I have a backlog of material that I can cut into videos. So this is me trying to get ahead a little bit. I have a full-time job that keeps me pretty busy. And so this is not my primary thing. So I don't monetize my channel. Not that I have enough views or subscribers to really make it worthwhile. But this is something I enjoy doing. And I am doing it for fun. So, I'm walking down here. We're going to do a little experiment today. Yeah, hopefully I have enough stuff in my pocket. So, when I get where I'm going, I will come back to you. Alright? See you in a bit. Hey guys, how are you? Ah, so nice to be back. So, we're at the our little Taiga Island, modified Taiga Island, which it should have lit up enough that nothing's going to be spawning around here. Let's see if I've got some supplies in the chest here. Not really. Okay. Oh, I got some steak though. Very good. So I'm going to need to do. Ooh, but I have plenty of wood. Yeah. Okay. So. Let me try something. We're going to do a little experiment that will help. And I want to see something. So, give me a sec. Let me do some organization here, and I'll come right back to you. Ooh, I have smooth lighting turned off so I can see dark spots like this. That's not too dark. This is pretty dark looking, so we need to make sure that we're well lit here, because I don't need creepers just showing up. And I need to root out and see if there's some spots of the island here that should be covered in grass that are not. I suspect that there are, so we'll figure that out. Hello, Mr. Skeleton. Can I hit you from here? Oh. Ha. Okay, so, that was weird, something just died over there. Oh, there's a witch. Interesting. Okay, so, this is Taiga. I think some of that's Taiga, and I think that's Taiga. And what I wanted to see Looks like I've explored it. What I wanted to see was if, as a taiga, it counts as a cold biome. Hello. Oh, he's got a flame bow on him. Wow. Where'd he come from? So there must be a dark spot over here. Oh, there's a bunch of it. Okay, there we go. That's much better. Wow. Hey. Yeah, so I was watching Fog's World, and he went and built an ice. He went and built an ice tree in a taiga biome. Right, and we are in a taiga. So I want to see, is this taiga over here? Yes, excellent. So, we're at about sea level. So, I want to see something. Okay, notice it's raining, which is actually helpful, because what I want to see is, in theory, if the water can freeze up here, it should start to snow. At least that's my understanding. I could be wrong about that, but let's go up to, whoop. I have to be a little careful. Oh, look, there's snow over there. Wait. We're in a taiga. Why is it snowing over there, but not where I'm standing? Oh, now it's snowing here. What level am I at? 143. Can we go up to 150? Oh, and then grab this. Right? And I want to try something. In theory, I didn't need those other. Oh shoot! Hey, look at that. That's exciting. I don't have enough blocks, but we'll just do this. And if we put water down, in theory, if I wait long enough, it should freeze. The fact that snow is accumulating here is a good sign. Oh, be careful. And I did bring more water. I should have brought a lot more water. Should have brought enough to make a little ice farm. But I only have the two buckets. Obviously, I'm surrounded by water here. It is an island, mostly. What is that? Huh. Hey, look! I've got ice! Oh my gosh! It's my first ice on the server. That's exciting, because I could use ice. I could use lots of ice. Is the sun coming up? The sun is starting to come up. I wonder if it'll freeze any better if I go up higher. Oh, the snow is so pretty. Let me get a nice screenshot here. It's raining over there, so that must be outside of the biome. Oh, let me do this. I don't want to do hitboxes. There we go. Chunk borders. So if I make myself an ice farm, probably, oh, we're right on the edge here. Probably want to do it in a chunk that is entirely taiga. Come on, you can freeze. Oh, wow. That's kind of cool. Wonder what the blue lines are. Wait, are they, So we're at 150 here. I wonder if they're at increments of 8. Probably are. Okay, you could freeze at any time now, Mr. Ice. And I don't have a good source of snowballs either. Ah, now I have snowballs too, which means I can make snow blocks. This is super exciting. I'm very, very, very excited about this. I didn't bring any slabs. I didn't bring much of anything that I really needed. All right, so this is good. So Taiga is good for freezing. You know, the rain there is probably because it's beach over there. So I'll go in, I'll probably build on maybe that chunk, or maybe I'll go over to like here, because I'm not using that Taiga and stuff won't spawn if it doesn't have sky access, I believe. You know, mobs won't spawn if they don't have sky access. So perhaps I should build an ice tray above one of these islands over here. Maybe this one, because I do have a little isthmus here, a little sandbar to walk over there. If I can find a good taiga chunk over there, go up to build limit and build myself an ice cube, an ice farm. Either build it the way I have been building them, or it would be kind of cool to build like an automated ice thing that builds an ice cube so that I can just go harvest a bunch of it at once. Come on, you could freeze. 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 But I do have ice. That's so excited. So exciting. I still need to find an ice spikes biome. Oh, hello, Mr. Snow. Yeah. Because I would like to get some packed ice. I don't think I found one yet. Have I? I don't think so. I'll have to look. I don't know that I have like an ice or like a water chest back at the base. Come on, you could freeze. Wonder if it freezes quicker if it's higher up. I think I already said that, which is not great. But the cool thing about having ice, a couple cool things. One is I can use it to move items into a collection system in for the gold farm, which would be nice. Experience points and items slide across ice really quickly. I know the water won't freeze if it doesn't have sky access. I know that's the case. So this one's taking a long time to freeze. Let's go up higher. I want to leave a little space at the top. I don't want to go all the way up to build limit, because if I want to build an ice cube thing, I need at least 12 spaces, 13 spaces at the top. So maybe if I go up to like 200, that'll leave plenty of space for redstone contraptions. I got more wood here. Oh, that was frightening. Oh, goodness. Oh, goodness. But I did not fall. Oh, but it felt like I was going to. Now, I'm wearing the Elytra, so I guess it wouldn't have been that big of a deal. But that was frightening. Okay, water. You can freeze. So that must be build limit up there. Yeah, I bet the blue lines are at 8. The red lines, I wonder what the red lines are. Is that the next chunk over? I wonder. Huh. So the yellow, I mean, basically I've got the grid. I've got the chunk boundaries turned on, so you can see where the chunks are, which is super handy, super helpful. And so this box shows the chunk that I'm currently in. And notice it's snowing entirely in that chunk, which is good. Hello, snow. Did I pick up? Nice. My pings are not super awesome right now, but nice, there we go. And if I get enough snow, of course, I can make a snowman. Meaning I can make a snow farm. Let's compact the snow a bit. Come on, ice, you can freeze. Oh, goodness. So it's raining over there, which looks like the beach. This looks like beach over there, too. So it's raining on that part. Oh, interesting. Oh, that's right. That's the way they do the snow. Falling right directly above you or directly below you, it's always going to be. The snow isn't going to be there. They're basically rotating walls around you with the snow texture. It's kind of cool. It's super pretty. The other nice thing about ice, very useful use for ice, is that it's basically stackable water. Or you can stack buckets, but once you put water in the bucket, you cannot stack it any longer. But you can stack ice. So if you place ice and break it, of course, it turns into water. Well, that's scary. Come on, water, you can break. Oh, I mean, water, you can freeze. Now, will it freeze even though it's not snowing? That was weird that we had thunder and then it just stopped. I wonder if there's a horseman trap down there somewhere then. If that was just normal thunder or something else. Huh. Come on, you can freeze, right? Okay, so it's taken a long time to freeze up here, too. We're pretty high up, so I don't know that above a certain height, I don't know if it matters. So I'm going to have to go look at the wiki and see. Oh, hello, Mr. Ice. Welcome. Woohoo. Okay, so now we can do this. All right, so now I need to clean up a little bit here. If I had built all the way up here to start with, I wouldn't have to worry about the fact that I've got a platform down there where stuff can spawn. That's not good. So I'm gonna have to clean up after myself a little bit here. So, but you don't need to see that. It's gonna be boring. But I'm glad to know that I can actually build in a taiga biome here. I can build an ice farm because I can use ice more than the two blocks that I currently have. So, the question is, how do I go about doing that? I can build it the way I've traditionally been building them, which is to build out basically a shallow pan, and then last season I did one with pistons. I'll have to go back and look at how I built that one. Water freezes more quickly when it has the solid block next to it. Okay, we're lagging a little bit here. Let the server catch up. So by building the water and pushing blocks of snow or some other block up inside it, made it so that it froze more quickly, which was convenient. And then I could retract them to go and collect all the ice. And then put them back up, reflood it with water, put the blocks. Oh, look, yes, indeed. Do I want a skeleton horse? Oh, I don't know. Should I go? My armor is in pretty good shape. I hate when in the water they're not. They're kind of a pain in the butt. Yeah. Okay. We'll leave him alone. Cool. Well, that's what I needed. Oh, let's go fill up my buckets so I have more water to do more testing with. And go put some of the stuff away. And go start a chest of water supplies back at the base. And put some of these building supplies back in my little hut here. I wonder how close you have to get to trigger the skeleton trap. There we go. Cool. Okay, well, that was good. That was what I wanted to figure out for today. Was, can I freeze water here? And the answer, apparently, is yes. Which is very exciting. So, very nice. I think that will do it for now. I will go figure out a good spot to... Oh, no, I'm going to take this with me. Figure out a good spot to go build the actual thing. Can I shoot him dead here? What happens if you kill the horse? He's taking damage. And obviously that then doesn't trigger the trap. Huh. So that's one way of avoiding it. Hello, squiddies. Is that just experience? Oh no, that's one of my arrows. Okay. Well, we learned something today. A couple things. Cool. So I'm going to build that, and then I need to pretty this place up a little bit. Figure out a good way of making it a little bit more fun to hang around here. That tall grass over there looks like creepers. I need to go get rid of it. But I'll wait till the morning. So I think that's going to be it for this episode. Thank you for watching. I'm going to figure out where to make myself some more ice. And then I will show you when I have more of that set up. And obviously I need to make more progress on the gold farm too. But that's it for now. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. All right, bye.